Exercise 22B, 13th problem. The length of the shadow of a tower. This is the tower, this is the shadow. This length, standing on level plane, is found to be 2y meters longer when the sun's altitude is 30 degree than when it was 45 degree. Suppose the shadow, here it is 45 degree, here it is 30 degree. This is 2y meters longer. This shadow is 2y meters longer when sun's altitude is 30 degree than when it was 45 degree. When the sun's altitude is 45 degree, the shadow is this much. When it is 30 degree, the shadow is this much longer, that is 2y meter. Prove that the height of the tower is y into square root of 3 plus 1. You have to prove that the height is equal to y into square root of 3 plus 1. Let the height be h. Therefore, the length of the shadow when the altitude is 45 degree will also be equal to h, because tan 45 is equal to 1. H upon h is equal to 1. Now this distance, the length of this shadow, is equal to h plus 2y. So tan 30 is equal to h upon h plus 2y. Tan 30 is equal to 1 upon square root of 3. H upon h plus 2y. H plus 2y goes to the numerator, square root of 3 goes to the numerator. H plus 2y is equal to square root of 3h. 2y is equal to square root of 3h minus h. H is common here, square root of 3 minus 1. 2y is equal to h into square root of 3 minus 1. So height is equal to what? 2y upon square root of 3 minus 1. H is equal to 2y upon square root of 3 minus 1. Let us rationalize the denominator. Square root of 3 plus 1. Square root of 3 plus 1. So that the whole value remains 1. A minus b into a plus b is equal to a squared minus b squared, right? So this is 2y into square root of 3 plus 1. Upon a minus b into a plus b is equal to a squared minus b squared. A squared here is 3. Minus b squared here is 1. 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. 2 gets cut off. So h is equal to y into square root of 3 plus 1. We have proved that the height is equal to y into square root of 3 plus 1. 14th problem. An aeroplane flying horizontally 1 kilometer above the ground. If this is the ground, 1 kilometer above the ground. 1 kilometer. And going away from the observer. Suppose the observer is here, the aeroplane is going away. Is observed at an elevation of 60 degree. This is observed here. At an elevation of 60 degree. After 10 seconds, its elevation is observed to be 30 degree. Suppose after 10 seconds it reaches this point, the elevation is this 30 degree. Find the uniform speed of the aeroplane in kilometer per hour. This is 10 seconds, this is 1 kilometer. So this is 30, means this is also 30. This is 60, so this is 60 degree. Let this distance be x and this distance be y. So tan 30 is equal to 1 upon x. Tan 30 is equal to 1 upon x. Tan 60 is equal to 1 upon y. Tan 60 is equal to 1 upon y. 1 upon square root of 3 is equal to 1 upon x. 1 upon square root of 3 is equal to 1 upon x, or x is equal to square root of 3. Square root of 3 is equal to 1 upon y, or y is equal to 1 upon square root of 3. Now this distance is equal to what? X minus y. So the distance is equal to x minus y. X is what? Square root of 3. Minus y is equal to 1 upon square root of 3. LCM is equal to square root of 3. Square root of 3 into square root of 3 is equal to 3 minus 1. Distance is equal to 2 upon square root of 3. Distance is equal to 2 upon square root of 3 kilometer. Time is equal to 10 seconds. So speed is equal to distance divided by time. So divided by time is 10 seconds. In hour, 10 divided by 3600. Ten seconds is equal to 10 upon 3600 hour, right? 10 upon 3600. 3600 goes to the numerator. Seven 20 upon square root of 3. Let us rationalize the denominator. This becomes 3. 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12. 240 into square root of 3. 1.732 into 240 is equal to what? 123. The speed of the aeroplane is equal to 415.68 kilometer per hour. 15th problem, from the top of a hill, suppose this is the hill, from the top of a hill, the angles of depression of two consecutive kilometer stones, suppose two consecutive kilometer stones are here, the angle of depression, angle of depression, due east are found to be 30 degree and 45 degree respectively, 30 degree and 45 degree respectively. So this is 30 degree, this is 45 degree. Find the distances of the two stones from the foot of the hill. The distance between two consecutive stones is equal to 1 kilometer, right? Let the distance of one stone from the foot of the hill be x. Since this angle is 45 degree, tan 45 is equal to 1. Therefore, the height of the cliff is also equal to x. Tan 45 is equal to x upon x. Tan 45 is equal to 1. We have to find x and x plus 1. Tan 30 is equal to x upon x plus 1. 1 upon square root of 3 is equal to x upon x plus 1. X plus 1 is equal to square root of 3x. So 1 is equal to 1.732 minus 1. 0.732x. Therefore x is equal to 1 divided by 0.732. 1 divided by 0.732. The next number will be less than 5, so let us stop here. 1.366. X is equal to 1.366. So distance of one stone from the foot of the hill is equal to 1.366 kilometer, and the distance of another stone from the foot of the hill is equal to this plus 1 kilometer. This is 2.366 kilometer.